everyone thinks that you study the elderly. And okay, you know, you study just older adults, and that's one of the things that we do, but also one of the catchphrases in gerontology is that we're all aging. And that's one of the things that they like to emphasize, is that it's a lifelong process, and everybody goes through the process of aging. Everybody will, hopefully, if they're lucky, be able to go through the process of aging. And so it's something that affects all of us, and it's not necessarily focused on one finite age group.
I teach a course, a gender in the life course, and you know, they automatically think we're going to talk about women and, you know, older women. And I, you know, I say the same thing, that, you know, aging is a process, and that we are really looking at kind of life course issues.
The gerontology program is actually very unique. It offers a PhD, but there's no actual department of gerontology. Because the field of gerontology is so interdisciplinary to its core, we actually put together a PhD program from two universities. There's medical aspects of gerontology, which includes epidemiologists and public health, and those are actually located at UMB, people with that specialty. And there's the social gerontology aspect, which is one of our specializations, and that's housed in the sociology and anthropology department here at UMBC.
And students have the opportunity to work across campus with different members of the faculty, and also choose their own research track, their research interests, and can kind of collaborate with faculty members, develop mentoring relationships across campus. Christine's work is highly quantitative. I'm, you know, starting to do more qualitative work. And the fact that, you know, we can all, you know, kind of work together in building a research agenda is very important to the field, to, you know, kind of pushing the field forward, I think.
Brandy's point is spot on about the different methods. There's a great deal of variety, but, you know, we know there's, you may have a social problem, and the many different ways that you can look at it, however many different lenses or ways you can collect data, just get you more closer and closer to the truth of being able to kind of figure out what's actually going on in the social world. Gerontology as a core of a discipline has always been clinicians, sociologists, anthropologists, epidemiologists, public health scholars, policy.
Different voices represented really helps us to get a good picture of what's going on.
It's great to be kind of, you know, challenged outside of what you know, and that's part of the fun of it. So right now I'm working on a project that looks at who do older adults think should care for them when they're older. And this is actually quite an important question, because first, it's not asked very often on large surveys. And we have to, you know, in order to promote a positive social environment, for example, if an older adult desires a family member to care for them, but they're in a formal care setting, they may have elevated depression because it's a mismatch with their expectations. One of the things that I did find looking at a cross-national sample in Europe was that older adults that live in countries that place a high degree of emphasis on the family actually get a stronger health kickback when they have interactions with their family and are cared for by their family. So it's really important when we're thinking about how to design programs that will promote the happiest, you know, not just a longer life, but also a happier life for older adults.
I focus on healthcare workers, in particular healthcare workers providing care for older adults in senior housing settings. I was funded through NIA to do work focusing on direct caregivers in assisted living, learning more about their attitudes toward providing care to older adults. I really just, you know, think it's so important that you know, we provide the best care for our older adults in these settings. So to have a workforce that is engaged and happy about the work that they're doing, I think is so important. And so I hope that my work can help influence that.